Consultations with new patients are possibly the most important appointments that they can have. Gives me the opportunity to evaluate a patient's goals, perform a detailed physical examination, and then formulate a plan. It is very common that more than one option is available, and it's important to make the proper choice with every patient. I prefer to be very hands-on and to handle these consultations myself rather than rely on staff consultants. There has never been a better time to pursue cosmetic procedures in my view. In addition to surgery, there are all sorts of minimally invasive, minimal incision techniques, injectables that smooth and fill and make up for the aging process. There are lasers and light therapies, collagen stimulating therapies, and all sorts of topical skin therapies. And all of these can be blended together to make a custom plan for each individual. So I feel very privileged as a board certified plastic surgeon to be able to say I can offer the full range of available services from simple topical therapy all the way up to complicated surgery. The foundation or key to getting the best results often begins with credentialing and training. I'm a proud member of the American Society of Plastic Surgeons and the American Society for Aesthetic Plastic Surgery, and there are very few members of both of these around the world. In order to maintain your membership, there are rigid requirements, not only including board certification, but also high standards of continuing education, the requirement to work at certain surgical facilities, and specific ethical standards. I've come up with the 9 keys to success in plastic and cosmetic surgery from the patient perspective. 1, establish clear goals before you go for a consultation. 2, find the properly credentialed person, a real expert. 3, find a surgeon with the right fit for you. 4, learn about the procedure and educate yourself from reliable sources. 5, plan your budget so that you know what you'll be expensing. 6, prepare for surgery and use your physician and office as the key guides. 7, follow instructions carefully once you have the procedure done. 8, keep your follow-up appointments. And finally, 9, be patient.